Hi guys, my name is Anuj Jindal. Welcome to Morning Tales for September 12, 2019. Neha is not well, so I have to take Morning Tales for you guys because we don't want to create any break in the Morning Tales. So here I am. Let's discuss some questions for September 12. The first question that we have today is where will India's first international women trade center be built? The answer to this question is Kerala, and the purpose, which is important from understanding point of view of International Women Trade Center, is to enable a lot of women to sell their products and be more successful entrepreneurs or businesswomen. So a shop like a big shopping complex is going to be developed where people can come and shop, and people, women, can come and sell and create their own stalls. So that's the entire purpose of International Women Trade Center, which is going to be India's first to be set up in Kerala. The second question is, according to the first ever digital economy report 2019, global internet protocol IP traffic will increase to dash per second by 2022. Now, the traffic had increased in 2017 to 45,000 gigabytes per second in 2017, and by 2022 it is projected that it will increase to 150,700. Now this is only one fact that I have picked up from the digital economy report, but there are a lot of other facts which are also important, and I expect you and I request you to go through the entire report. It is very well created through charts, and therefore you can easily find out all the important facts and cover them. Although they are also being covered in Spotlight, so you don't have to worry if you want to wait for some time. You can do that. As soon as Spotlight for September is published, you will also get all these data. But I would recommend that you go through it, spend at least 15-20 minutes and go through the entire Digital Economy Report 2019. Which company has been chosen by Niti Aayog for developing India's first digital capability center? Now, digital capability center has been developed in India. McKinsey has already developed such centers in countries around the world in various cities. And now Niti Aayog has asked McKinsey to create such a center in India as well. Okay. The next question is, which school has topped in the global top 50 IB schools 2019 list? This school has for the first time come in top 50 schools, IB schools, and the rank is at number 10. And the answer to this question is Dhirubhai Ambani International School, DAIS. The rank, the score is 39.5 in 2019, and the rank is 10, as I said. So those are another two questions that can be asked in the examination. What is the name of the app launched by Ministry of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare to facilitate easy borrowing of farm equipment by farmers? This app, as you can see in the picture also, is named as CHC Farm Machinery, and this app has been created by Ministry of Agriculture itself. The purpose is farm equipment should be easy to lend and borrow among farmers, and also between farmers as well as banks and organizations which create these farm equipments. So the answer is CHC Farm Machinery. The purpose is to create a marketplace for equipments which could be used in farming. Which country is the latest one to join the Shanghai Cooperation Group or Shanghai Cooperation Organization in 2017? So there are a total of 8 members. All the members, let's say Uzbekistan, Kyrgyzstan, other than Uzbekistan, all the members were a part of the group in 1996. A total of 5 members were a part of the group in 1996. In 2001, Uzbekistan entered Shanghai Cooperation Organization, and now we have Pakistan and India entering the organization in 2017. So the answer to this question is Pakistan, because India is not mentioned. Remember, Iran is not even a member of the organization. The next question is, where is the headquarter of OECD? OECD stands for Organization for Economic Cooperation and Development, and the headquarters are in Paris, France. Which organization releases the World Economic Outlook report? Now, World Economic Outlook is a financial report which is released every year by IMF, International Monetary Fund, and there's also a meeting of governors as well as prime ministers which is held every year, preferably in Switzerland, under World Economic Outlook. Okay, so the answer to this question is International Monetary Fund. The last question for today is, where was Asia Pacific Economic Cooperation established? When was Asia Pacific Economic Cooperation established? Now, APEC is an organization with its headquarters in Singapore, and it was created in Australia. It is an organization of 21 members in the Pacific region. The main purpose of Asia Pacific Economic Cooperation, as is very visible from the name itself, is to promote free trade agreements in the entire world. It was created in the year 1989. Okay, so these all were the questions from the morning tales for today. I hope Neha will be back soon and she will be able to take much more detailed, because she's the one who handles the entire spotlight work, and she's doing a beautiful job at ensuring that you don't miss out on anything in spotlight as well as in morning tales, and you're well prepared for phase one of RBI and SEBI examinations which are coming up. The development assistant examination is also about to happen. You don't have a lot of time, and all those students who are preparing or thinking of preparing for RBI and SEBI, I think it's a golden opportunity for you to start your preparations if you've not done so already. So start your preparations immediately with development assistant, because through that you'll be able to prepare a lot of things for RBI and SEBI as well, and that will automatically result in your in a better preparation as well as more chances of getting into organizations like NABARD as well. Okay, all the very best, take care, have a nice day.